And can you give a little brief history about your art education and your art, how you got started in the art field?
I wanted to make art from as early as I can remember. My family is involved in the arts, but I'm primarily self-taught in a small southern town.
And is that where you're from, actually?
From Asheboro, North Carolina.
Okay.
There are potters in the family, people that make wheels, a lot of crafts in North Carolina.
And this technique that you have now, when did you first start doing this?
The work that I'm doing now, the glass work, has a 25-year history with me. Many years ago, I worked in a stained glass studio, but my job wasn't to cut glass. I know how to cut glass. But in between that time and now, I've done lots of different kinds of work. I've done shrines, I've done collage, I've done clothing, art clothing, I've done shadow boxes. I really miss working in glass, so I wanted to get back to it, but I didn't want to make traditional stained glass windows. So the shadow boxes got thinner and thinner, and I had glass around the shop, and I was just kind of pushing around pieces of glass, and I thought, what if I work on the surface of my wood panels with mixed media and then put strips of glass, and maybe Swarovski crystals and other found materials, pieces of mother of pearl, maybe movie film, bread, anything I can get under there, so that you'll have this constantly undulating surface that changes with the light, like a stained glass window, except not from light going through it, but from reflection and refraction. Sometimes I use bevels as well, and I get that rainbow effect. And my subject matter, I read a lot about science, so I get a lot of my ideas from reading about quantum physics and things like that. Recently I've been reading about electromagnetic fields, and I really got interested in morphic fields. There's a scientist named Rupert Sheldrake who's doing some experiments now, blindfolding people, and some of these people can tell when they're being stared at and when they're not being stared at. So all around us are these magnetic fields, and this piece has hands in it, and also the glass, I'm thinking about the glass is like electromagnetic fields, and I have waves, and I have little bits of mother of pearl. But when I finished it, I call it morphic fields in Michelangelo. It was almost like it reminded me of the painting of Michelangelo's with God's hand reaching. So my next group of pieces will be related to electromagnetic fields. I did a lot of pieces that were about being inside buildings, looking out, outside buildings, looking in, and how the light reacted. And so I took some photographs. This is not from a photograph, but it helped me get started. Across the street from my house, there's a Confederate cemetery, and I was out there taking photographs in this little memorial house, and the light was streaming in on a sunny day.
Mm. All right. Okay, talk about this.
Sometimes I get an old window and actually collage the window panes, and I think it's just from my stained glass days when I've worked on a body of work that doesn't have clear glass like this. I like to make one in between. This piece is about morphic fields and the sixth sense. We think, well, scientists think that birds use morphic fields to navigate navigate and butterflies. And it's about ideas and how they might travel from one group of people to another. A lot of my artwork is based on my reading life, and I read The Glass Room by Simon Maurer, and it was about a 1920s Bauhaus-style house and the effect that contemporary architecture had on all the people that lived in the house. So it went from the 20s up to, I think, the 80s or 90s, all through the Nazi occupation of the house. I think it was in Czechoslovakia. It was fiction, but it was a real, he based it on a real house that actually exists. So I made this piece because that, I just kept thinking about that house and the people in the glass room and how the glass room changed them and how contemporary architecture changed them. This is my studio at Art Space, North Carolina, in Raleigh, the capital city. I've been here for 25 years. And I don't have a lot of room to work, but I make a good use of the room I do have to work. I cut glass in here, collage in here, paint. Usually have a lot of things on the floor. This is my latest work I'm working on, about morphic fields, how we connect with one another just through vibrations, electromagnetic fields. I'm kind of at a loss now. After the tornadoes we had, I walked around and picked up roofing shingles and things. The title of this piece is Sliding Door. And it has a mate, which is in a gallery right now, but you look out, you see sort of a landscape, but then images of maybe a glass sliding door. But I really based it on a movie many years ago. Gwyneth Paltrow, I think, was in the movie, and it's about the different paths we take through the sliding door and how everything would be different if we'd chosen a different door, a different path. So I think of it as kind of like dimensions and extra dimensions and quantum physics. I enjoy being here at Art Space for many years because I meet all kinds of people. You come in and have a conversation about art. So I really appreciate your coming in today. We had a good conversation. Talk about quantum physics and fractals and algorithms. Those are interesting subjects.
Bye for now.
Yeah.
Okay.